And this is a part of a project, larger project that we started several years ago in the Southern Ocean, focusing in particular with on the response of the calcare nanofossil on paleoclimatic and paleoceanographic changes in the Eocene-Oligocene time interval. And you know that this middle Eocene-Oligocene time has been the scenario of paleoclimatic changes that record the cooling trend from the after the hyperthermal of the early Eocene up to the formation, the onset of the East Antarctic ice sheet in the earliest Oligocene. The transition of the Eocene-Oligocene that is dated between 34.5 to 33.5 million years ago is characterized mainly by a shift in the delta O18 value and also by perturbation of the carbon cycle by a sea level drop, a CCD deepening, and also a response in the biotic world, in the turnover in the biotic realm. In the marine realm in particular, several sites have been investigated in low and high latitude, but still we are lack of data in the Indian Ocean, in the equatorial Indian Ocean. For this reason, we focused in this site of LEG 115, site 711, that was published a few years ago by our group, and in this work, site 709, that is located in the equatorial Indian Ocean at this latitude, in a water depth of 3,000 meters about. The aim of this work is to reconstruct evidence by the behavior of calcareous nanofossil and reconstruct the sea surface temperature and the trophic condition of the interval from middle Eocene to early late Oligocene. For this purpose, we did a high-resolution quantitative study on calcareous nanofossil and new magnetostratigraphy, in particular in the Eocene and early Oligocene. And in addition, on the biostratigraphy, we were able to reconstruct paleoclimatic and paleoceanographic condition of this interval. So we perform quantitative analysis on 130 samples. The sample spacing is 10 centimeters. The slides were prepared according to the standard SMEAR slide. And we investigated an interval of 12 billion years. And in this interval, we evidenced 28 bioevents. From the first, the top of Chiasmolitos gigas to the top of Reticulofenestra umbilicus. So these events are indicated bioevents by these arrows, and in this list you can see the top and base common, top common, according to the indication of the paper of Bachmann et al. 2012. The age assignment of this bioevent is the benefit of the magnetostratigraphic work and the correlation with the biostratigraphy, as well as the data of the literature that were available. The paleomagnetism that was done on this score was done in Roma at the Institute of Geophysics and Vulcanology. And using 106 cubic samples, while the upper part, we have some data also in the early Oligocene, were processed in the lab of paleomagnetismo dell'Università de São Paulo in Brazil. Thanks to this data, we could perform an age model and magnetobiochronology. And the definition of the chronozone, were done according to plotting against the geopolarity time scale and with the help, of course, of the position of the bioevents. According to this reconstruction, we were able to see in particular two hiatus. So plotting the biozone recognized again and the bioevents against the magnetostratigraphy, we saw these two main hiatus. The lower one, the lowest one, is it comprises the Kron, almost all the Kron C19N that you can see is very short, and some part of the upper part of C19R. We could reconstruct this chronology thanks to the presence of the bottom of common of Cribrocentrum reticulatum that, according to Agnini and other authors, occurs in the lower part of C19R. The highest hiatus is recognizable by the synchronous top or extinction or disappearance of Discoaster saipanensis, Discoaster barbariensis, Cribrocentrum cericulatum, Cribrocentrum isabelle, that usually are spaced in time, and that this different time have been seen both in literature and in the nearby site 7-Eleven that we studied a few years ago. So this hiatus is including at least C13R, and we, in terms of biozone, is including erasing CNE20, but the presence, thanks to the presence, just above the hiatus of Clausicoccus SPP, that we think is representative of a high abundance of Clausicoccus subdisticus that should appear at the very base of CNO1. We think that also CNE21 is missing in the hiatus, so it's a pretty high, thick hiatus. Then we converted for paleoecological reconstruction the database, the abundance of the nanofossils that were plotted before in terms of a number on a fixed area in millimeter square. Converting in percentage, we could use the abundance of the percentage of this species or group or genus for paleoecological behavior and paleo-oceanographic reconstruction. So thanks to this, to the literature, we use only taxa where there is a great consensus about their behavior. So we grouped warm water taxa that comprise Discoaster SPP, Ericksonia formosa, and Sphenolithus SPP. While in the oligotrophic taxa group, we included Discoaster and Ericksonia formosa. The eutrophic taxa consists of Reticulofenestra daviesi, Ciclogradino floridanus, and Reticulofenestra as a group SPP. What we could see from the plotting of this three main groups is from the bottom we see different behavior, and also we performed a multivariate analysis using the PCA analysis, and the factor one of the PCA was associated to the paleoclimatic factor sea surface temperature. Why? Because it has a very similar behavior to the delta O18 presented in paper of Boati et al. 2009 on the Middle Eocene, where we can see this shift from a relatively low value, this shift to positive value, that indicate, in our opinion, a cooling event followed by a very sharp other peak toward warm condition. And this could be related to the pre-MECO event and the real MECO event. MECO stands for Middle Eocene Climatic Optimum, that is dated at 40 million years ago. And if you go to the warm water taxa behavior, we see exactly at 40.2 million years the peak in abundance of this group of warm taxa. above, we can see instead at 2,095 meters a decrease in warm water taxa. This event that is dated in correspond to C17N is correlated with the cooling event that was labeled as cooling sea in our work in the Southern Ocean, and lately also defined in other area as the pre-Abonian oxygen maximum. So it means a cooling event at about 37 million years ago. The other factor of the PCA, the factor 2, is keeps value almost constant or positive until the 2087 meter, and in correspondence of the base of Kron C15N, dated at 35.2 million years. This may indicate, comparing to the other group of oligotrophic and trophic taxa, a change in the surface nutrient regime, and could be the response of significant change in the paleoceanographic configuration at high latitude and the response in low latitude. This could be confirmed by the that is known from the literature that the initiation of the Antarctic circumpolar current started at about 35.5 million years. Also bottoms, this is a surface water. Also bottom water paleocurrent around Antarctica, according to recent work, have been established to start about 35.7. So it's a fundamental change in the oceanographic circulation that can be just later have a response in the equatorial ocean. On top of this, we have the hiatus I mentioned before. This hiatus is involved a lot of time in terms of C13R and part probably of C15N, and is just opposing a relevant change between of eutrophic taxa in the early Oligocene. This change could be again a response in the reorganization of the nutrient regime, and to have a link again with the circulation of the ocean at high latitude. In the sense that it could be linked to the formation of high latitude nutrient rich water that started from the Antarctica, and like the subantarctic mud water, the SAMU, according to Sarmiento et al. 2004. And so we speculate that this change in circulation, well before the OI1, the oxygen isotope shift for the Oligocene, could have enhanced the mixing also at low latitude, and consequently the eutrophication of the surface water, and have a response so of the eutrophic nanofossil taxa. Then in the latest upper part with the low resolution sampling, you can see is much less the resolution, we could see again with the grouping in percentage of warm water tax, oligotrophic tax, eutrophic tax, that the warm water tax keep after the cooling of the early Oligocene tend to increase slowly up to a peak in the high, in the late Oligocene, and this southern ocean, as well by oxygen isotope, by Packer et al. In 2004, and in another area by Wu et al. 2018. Thank you, in particular, for your attention. That is not so easy to keep attention in this system. Thank you.